AMD Ryzen 5000 series has survived two generations of Intel competition, but with Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake on the horizon, let's take a look at the next generation's Ryzen 7000 series CPUs. The initial lineup still features the same core configurations. Under the hood, the new Zen 4 architecture promises an average of 13% increase in IPC, as well as double of L2 cache. AMD has also moved manufacturing to TSMC's 5-nanometer process. There's also improved clock speeds, which brings an increase in power consumption, plus significant motherboard requirement changes with the Zen 4 CPUs. Base clock speeds are 1 GHz higher than the 5000 series, while max boosting frequencies being several hundred megahertz higher. This is also possible due to higher power limits. On the low end, the 7600X with 6 cores and 12 threads will be 65 watts, and the top end 7950X with 16 cores and 32 threads will be 170 watts. For our testing, we use both DDR5 in the AMD and Intel benches to keep the systems as equal as possible. Both AMD and Intel are pushing the cooling requirements. Obviously, benchmarks are meant to push any system to its limits and are not how normal people use their computers. A visual change to Zen 4 is the new IHS being designed with 8 legs that attach the ISH to the chip. We used a Ryzen 9000 7900X with 12 cores and 24 threads, up to 5.6 GHz, which got very, very hot. We used an ASUS X670EI gaming Wi-Fi motherboard and a Kingston Fury Renegade DDR5 2x16GB sticks. The Intel 12900 we used was a MSI Z690 Tomahawk with the same DDR5 memory. We also have the 5950X and the 5900X on the MSI X570 Ace with Crucible DDR4 benchmarks. The 7900X in software reported power consumption is 235 watts, with a total system power consumption at the wall of 330 watts, where the 12900 still consumes far more power, clocking in at 284 watts in software and 388 watts at the wall. We're still using a 360 AIO, and the 7900X still hits 95C in the test and throttles after about a minute. The 12900KF is outputting an additional 50 watts, and yet still levels off at around 86C without throttling. This is also a pre-release BIOS, and with any launch, it takes a few weeks or so for new BIO updates to come out that should improve the performance of the system. In Cinebench R23 multi-thread, the 7900X scored a whopping 35% higher than its predecessor, the 5900X. Compared to the 12900KF, the 7900X scores 8% higher. In a single thread, the 7900X is 24% faster than the 5900X and just 2% ahead of the 12900KF. Moving on to rendering, we have a shift in the benchmark with Blender version 3.3, hence we only have the data for the 12900 and the 7900 CPUs. In this series of tests, the 7900X took about 15% longer than the 12900, a disappointing result for the 7900. In the V-Ray, the 7900 scores 37% ahead of its predecessor and 24% ahead of the 12900KF. Of course, the CPUs are not the only talking point. Together with a Ryzen 7000, AMD is debuting a new socket for their consumer motherboards and a new chipset, PCIe 5.0 and of course DDR5. Starting with the socket, AM5 is now an LGA socket, just like the AMD Threadripper CPUs. This means the pins are in the motherboard and not on the CPU itself. Cooler backwards compatibility is somewhat maintained from AM4. As the backplate is now fixed to the motherboard, AM4 mounts that require a different backplate are not compatible. Mounts that use the screw points or plastic clips are fully compatible still. Moving on to the chipset, AMD is launching 4 motherboards, the X670, Extreme and Non-Extreme, and the B650 Extreme and Non-Extreme. The Extreme will have all the best features, and the Non-Extreme will have a mixed match. It's best to check with the product specs before buying the Non-Extremes to make sure the features match what you're looking for. AMD states the AM4 coolers are compatible with the new AM5 motherboards, but there is a catch. AM4 coolers are only compatible if the cooling mounting uses AMD's standard clip mechanism or AM4 backplate. For example, the Corsair cooler that we used mounts directly to the holes provided by the AM4 backplate, and we can mount it directly to the same holes on the AM5. If your cooler mounts require the AM4 backplate to be swapped out for a different backplate, then it's not compatible with AM5. This is as AM5's backplate is fixed to the motherboard and cannot be removed. So make sure you check with your cooler before buying or upgrading to a newer one. In conclusion, the AMD Ryzen 7900X is a powerful performing CPU in most of our benchmarks. It has better power consumption than the Intel current generation, but is far more demanding than the previous AMD 5000 series. We also feel anyone planning to upgrade should consider the possibility of having to upgrade their existing power supply and CPU cooler. From all of us at Dreamcore, thanks, and we will see you in the next video.